I'm Donna Cruz, along with Keith Stevens, and you found a place where encouragement becomes contagious, Keep the Faith. And that name has never meant more than it does right now. You will make it through this time.
With illness and job losses, the clouds overhead are dark, but there is good news. You've been given access to everything you need to weather the storm. So all the songs and stories in this hour have been chosen to help you find faith in your challenges and see the sun again. And here's a taste.
There's never been a moment I was not held beside your arms.
And I looked down the hallway and I could see her bedroom and she was kneeling at her bedside. She had her hands folded and I can hear her praying and she said, "Dear God, please give mommy the strength to fight breast cancer."
Angel is never worried about the things that everybody else is worried about. She doesn't worry about what's going to happen to the economy. She doesn't worry about what's going to happen to the weather. She doesn't even worry when Congress is in session.
I will fear no more.
When you're in a rainstorm, it's helpful to have an umbrella. But what tool do you have to weather the storms in your life? One mom's cancer battle holds the key. That story is next on Keep the Faith.
Is there anybody's sunshine been turned to rain? Is there anyone's blue sky been turned to gray? Is there anybody's good time turned out real bad? Is there anyone's happiness turned out sad? And I know I can't trust in the things that I see, in the things that I see.
Opportunities often come disguised as challenges. The songs and stories on Keep the Faith are designed to help you weather the storm and seize the day.
I was sure by now, God, you would have reached down and wiped our tears away, stepped in and saved the day. But
And once again, I say amen, and it's still raining. But as the thunder rolls, I barely hear you whisper through the rain, I'm with you. And as your mercy falls, I'll raise my hands and praise the God who gives and takes away. Praise you in the storm. I remember when I stumbled in the wind. You heard my cry to you and raised me up again. When my strength is almost gone, how can I carry on if I can't find you? As the thunder rolls, I barely hear you whisper through the rain, I'm with you. And as your mercy falls, I'll raise my hands and praise the God who gives and takes away.
Listening to Keep the Faith.
Hi, I'm Keith Stevens. So glad to have you along. Now, maybe you've heard the phrase, you're either in a crisis, coming out of one, or preparing for one. Kimberly Irvine is no stranger to adversity. At 31, she was diagnosed with breast cancer. Over the next decade, she endured a second cancer diagnosis, a divorce, and the struggles of being a single parent. Can you imagine? Now, in her book, Stronger, she shares about the main tool in her belt.
And I was so sick and I was so frail and I was sleeping on the couch. I was never in my bed because I was too weak to get up the stairs half the time. And she looked at me and said, Mommy, can you please tuck me into bed? And I was like, honey, Mommy is so tired. Daddy can just tuck you into bed. And she looked at me with her pretty little blue eyes and she put her hands on her hip in her little sassy way and she kind of stomps her feet and she's like, Mommy, you're always so sick and tired. You never tuck me into bed anymore. And I paused for a minute and I thought to myself, this is the reality of what a six-year-old child views from her mom. And I said, honey, go on up to bed. Mommy will tuck you in. I'll be there in just a moment. And so I looked at my husband. I said, you have to help me get up those stairs and tuck her into bed. And so as we got up the stairs, we stopped at the end of the hallway. And I looked down the hallway and I could see her bedroom and she was kneeling at her bedside. She had her hands folded and I can hear her praying. And she said, dear God, please give Mommy the strength to fight breast cancer. At that moment, tears rolled down my face. I fell to my knees and I literally prayed so hard to God that I would not only beat cancer, but show her the power of prayer and how important it was to lean into our faith when we had moments of just fear and anxiety and lack of control and uncertainty. And honestly, it really does come into play in any adversity. My kids know wholeheartedly that faith is really the instrumental component to whatever adversity that we face in life.
I'm not a warrior. I'm too afraid to lose. I feel unqualified for what you're calling me to. But Lord, with your strength, I got no excuse. 'Cause broken people are exactly who you use. So give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Boy, and made him a king. So I'm gonna trust you and give you everything. I'll be a conqueror, 'cause you fight for me. I'll be a champion, claiming your victory. So give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses. Shake the wall, won't stop until I see them fall. Gonna stand up, step out when you call. Jesus, Jesus, I'm gonna sing and shout and shake the wall. Won't stop until I see them fall. Gonna stand up, step out when you call. Jesus, give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses in the wilderness. Give me a heart like David. Lord, be my defense, so I can face my giants with confidence. Yeah! Give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses in the wilderness. My giants with confidence.
More than answers, our thinking should be geared around perspective. Because if we have perspective about our situation and perspective about what we're going through, then that brings calm. Calm leads to clear thinking. Clear thinking yields ideas, and ideas are how God reveals His answers.
Listen to this hour of Keep the Faith over and over, and share with a friend as well. You'll find it on our KeepTheFaith.com YouTube channel.
Sheila Walsh used to hike mountains in Scotland and noticed something interesting about valleys that can encourage you as you weather the storms in your life. That's next on Keep the Faith.
They say sometimes you win some, sometimes you lose some. And right now I'm losing bad. I've stood on this stage night after night, reminding the broken it'll be alright. But right now, oh, right now I
just came. It's easy to sing when there's nothing to bring me down. But what will I say when I'm held to the flame like I am right now? They say it only takes a little faith to move a mountain. Well, good thing a little faith is all I have right now. God, when you choose to leave mountains unmovable, oh, give me the strength to be able to sing. It is well with my soul. I know you're able and I know you can save through the fire with your mighty hand. But even if you don't, my hope is you alone. I know the sorrow and I know the hurt would all go away. Jesus, I will cling to you, come what may, 'cause I know you're able, I know.
Storms can make you stronger with a greater capacity to help others. As you listen to Keep the Faith, each song has been carefully chosen to share the encouragement you need.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by, T-Mac on the radio. Got so much on your mind, nothing's really going right. Looking for a ray of hope. Whatever it is you may be going through, I know it's not gonna let it get the best of you. You're an overcomer. Stay in the fight till the final round. You're not going under, 'cause God is
You're listening to Keep the Faith.
I'm Donna Cruz. One of the most difficult things to have is patience in the storm. As a singer, speaker, and best-selling author, Sheila Walsh has had plenty of highs, but as she shares in her books like In the Middle of the Mess, some of her low points have been the most valuable.
I remembered an experience I had when I was 19 in Scotland, and my friends and I went on a hiking trip into the Scottish Highlands, and we climbed up one particular mountain. And what I remember about it was that the view from the top was breathtaking, but the air was very thin and nothing was really growing up there, but it was still a glorious view. But when we climbed back down that night to the valley, to where the river was running through, that's where all the life was. That it was lush down there and things were growing, things were changing. And even though it was darker and you couldn't see ahead, stuff happens there. I'm learning that if I find myself in a dry season or a place where I feel like I'm in that valley place, I'm learning not to rush through, because God has a purpose for that. If you pray, God, give me eyes to see what I'm going to miss. When you come out of a place like that, you're changed.
I've walked among the shadows, you wipe my tears away, and I've felt the pain of heartbreak, and I've seen the brighter days, and I've prayed prayers to heaven from my lowest place, and I have held your blessings, God, you give and take away. No matter what I have, your grace is enough. No matter where I am, I'm standing in your love. On the mountains, I will bow my life to the one who sent me there. In the valley, I will lift my eyes to the one who sees me there. When I'm standing on the mountain, I didn't get there on my own. When I'm walking through the valley, I know I am not alone. You're God of the my dreams get broken, in you I hope again. No matter what, I know I'm safe inside your hands. On the mountains, I will bow my life to the one who sent me there. In the valley, I will lift my eyes to the one who sees me there. When I'm standing on the mountain, I didn't get there on my own. When I'm walking, the of the hills and valleys, and I am not alone.
We've seen these videos of earthquakes where people are running and screaming, buildings imploding, and you know, people just went crazy and ran for their life because the earth is shifting. But today, you know, they've developed quote unquote earthquake proof buildings. And if you look at some of the videos of these online, you'll see that they're tall buildings in the biggest cities of the world. When an earthquake comes, they sway, but they don't implode. And I think that's how God wants us to build our faith, so that we're resilient, we bounce back. And when circumstances change, the earth starts to shift, we don't implode.
When I feel my heart about to break, I will cling to you.
Your prescription for hope is right here. You're listening to Keep the Faith, presented in part by CIA, Contagious Influencers of America podcast.
Coming up next on Keep the Faith, there's great value in finding the good in a challenge.
She doesn't worry about what's going to happen to the economy. She doesn't worry about what's going to happen to the weather. She doesn't even worry when Congress is in session.
For so long I carried the weight of my past, crippled by burdens like stones on my back. I thought I had fallen too far from your grace, but you came and showed me the way. When I was lost, so searching, you were the ground beneath my feet. When I was a blind man begging, you were the eye so I could see. When the smoke was rising up, now I'm alive and born again, rescued from the grip of sin. God, your love came crashing in and pulled me out of the fire. I'm a survivor. Now all I can see,
found the home of contagious encouragement, Keep the Faith. You can find more tools to help you weather the storms in your life at KeepTheFaith.com.
Have you been praying? and you still have no answers. Have you been pouring out your heart for so many years? Have you been hoping that things would have changed by now? Have you cried all the faith you have through so many tears? Don't forget the things that he has done before. And remember he can do it all once more. It's like the brightest sunrise waiting on the other side of the darkest night. Don't ever lose hope. Hold on and believe. Maybe you just haven't seen it. Just haven't seen it yet. You're closer than you think you are. Only moments from the break of dawn. All his promises are just up ahead. Maybe you just haven't seen it. Just haven't seen it yet.
Listening to Keep the Faith.
Hi, I'm Keith Stevens. It's one thing to go through a storm alone, but struggles, well, they're often shared. And how you share them goes a long way in how the storm can rage. In his book, 21 Irresistible Recipes for Couples, Keep the Faith's relationship chef, Joe Beam, has some insight called the bad day recipe.
Our first child was born a couple of years into our marriage. We call her Angel. Her name is Angela. Angela is mentally handicapped. She operates at about a slow 6-year-old level. There was a time when I felt some resistance to Alice after Angel was born, thinking, if you had taken better care of yourself when you were pregnant. Well, she did take care of herself, but you understand, I'm looking at her thinking, this is your fault. You did something wrong. Now we have this handicapped child. If you look at it from a different standpoint, thinking, bad things will happen. And rather than letting those things push you apart, you start looking at life differently. You reframe. For example, Angel is never worried about the things that everybody else is worried about. She doesn't worry about what's going to happen to the economy. She doesn't worry about what's going to happen to the weather. She doesn't even worry when Congress is in session. She is one happy little girl. My other daughters have married and moved away, but no boy will ever take this little girl away from me. And because I'm a Christian, I know that when she gets to the next life, she'll have everything all of us do. And so rather than looking at life as, I want everything to be perfect and I'm mad when it's not, you understand, sometimes life isn't perfect. But there are great blessings even in the imperfections. And that's the Band-Aid recipe to say, I'm with you today when it's good, I'm with you tomorrow when it's not. And when bad things happen, it won't pull us apart. It'll push us together as a team, and we'll face it together.
On the nights when the dark lasts a little bit longer, when the wind and the storm is a little bit stronger, when the fear in my heart digs a little bit deeper, and when my faith to stand gets a little bit weaker, where could I run to? Where could I go? Even when it feels like my world is shaking,
doesn't want us to have so many life jackets. He wants him to be the life jacket. And so if we hold on to our job as our life jacket, or our bank account as our life jacket, or our husband or spouse as our life jacket, all those things are temporary. God just wants to get us to hold on to the things that are permanent, and he's the only permanent thing in this world.
In the eye of the storm, you remain in control. My soul, you alone are the anchor. When my sails are torn, your love surrounds me. In the eye of the storm.
This is Keep the Faith.
Hi, I'm Paul Fredericks here on Keep the Faith with some contagious encouragement. It was Arthur Golden who said, adversity is like a strong wind. It tears away from us all but the things that cannot be torn, so that we see ourselves as we really are.
You're listening to Keep the Faith.
In the eye of the storm, you remain in control.
Yes, you do.
Hey, I'm Ryan Stevenson on Keep the Faith. There's so much joy to be found if you simply know where to look. You could shine the spotlight on it today. Our number is 800-726-4150. That's 800-726-4150.
During this crazy time, I can't really explain this incredible peace that God has given me. Each day, I go to work as an essential person, and I see the panic and I see the concern and fear, and I just go back to scripture and I see all the times that God has been faithful. And even in my own life, I look back at all the times that I've had to rely on God alone. And it just brings me so much peace and comfort knowing that we have such an awesome God who truly does love us, and He is with us even in the worst of the storm.
You're the only answer to the darkness. You're the only right among the wrong. You're the only hope among the chaos. You are the voice that calls me on. Louder than every lie, my sword in every fight, the truth will chase away the night. Your name is power over darkness, freedom for the captives, mercy for the broken and the hopeless. Your name is faithful in the battle, glory in the struggle.
Change is coming. Holy Spirit, let us see it.
When you speak, you scatter.